you know what? But that's the Daily Times ain't gonna report this story. You know why? Because Velocity Daily Times are tied in. Huh? No, they're not gonna report this story. And I'm glad to hear that. Because you know what? Velocity Daily Times ain't gonna report this story. You know why? Because Velocity Daily Times are tied in. Huh? No, they're not gonna report.
Greetings. I'm George Boston Rhines. I'm in Valdosta, Georgia. On the 25th of May, I was pulled over by a sheriff deputy here in Lowndes County, Georgia. And I was forbidden to enter high school graduation. You have seen my YouTube videos, and I have talked about my rights being denied. Yet, I have not received no politician, no civil rights organization, no political party, Democrat, Republican, Independent, nor Green Party. Yet my rights were violated, not by a Crip, not by a Blood, not by the New Black Panther Party, not by a member of the NAACP, SCLC, or any of these organizations, but by a member of law enforcement officer told me that I was under a criminal trespass warning that does not exist. Georgia Attorney General should be aware of what happened to George Boston Rhines. The United States Justice Department should be aware of what happened to George Boston Rhines, a retired military veteran in the United States of America. And so now, if I was charged with an invisible warning, the question that we all must look at, how many of our young people have been charged for obstruction of a police officer because they said it, but it was not true? How many of our young black and poor white children have been pulled over and charged for speeding in the state of Georgia when somebody lied on them? How many of our sons have been picked up in a lying jail for going or violating an illegal trespass, criminal trespass warning that they said existed on them, but like mine, it was not backed up by documentation? And so now we are living in America. Now, after I have thought about this and I've rethought what I was thinking about, and so I've come to the conclusion now, we are wondering why our young people are joining the Crips, the Bloods, and other organizations that they create themselves. If the men that wear the uniform is supposed to be the peacemakers, and if our young boys do not have any faith in the peacemakers that wear the uniform because they lie, then they got to create some organization and some unity, camaraderie with people whom they trust, because they don't trust the ones who wear the shield and David or the compass and the square hidden on the symbols of the law enforcement officers. If the Georgia Attorney General don't hear the cries of the suffering young folk, then what is our young people to do but to create games for their own self-protection? Because nobody will answer their call when they say, I've been to the local newspaper, I've been to the local television station, I've been to the local radio station, but they refuse to tell the story of our young people and what they are going through. And so what in the hell can they do but get into the Crips and the Bloods and the folk gangs? What else can they do? So now, because of what happened to me, I'm retired me. And so I think you are letting God use you for me to highlight that all of our black boys that are filling the jails and the prison system are not guilty. But somebody is lying on our young people, just like they lied on me. And I am a witness that the Justice Department don't seek justice no more. Those that wear the uniform and claim to be peace officers are not peace officers. Now, why would I say all this? Because Jesus said, "And ye shall know the truth, and that the truth shall set and make you free." And I want you to know today, make no mistake about me. I was born into the world to do what I'm doing. And God is just using people to show the world about America's democracy. In the state of Georgia, people now are beginning to see those men who wear the policeman's badge and the shield of David intertwined with the squared compass, representing peace, unity, and what God stood for. But if our young people cannot trust them, and if they don't trust the judicial system, and if they have lost faith in the judges because there is very little justice in the justice system for the poor and those who can't afford the expensive lawyers, and so they join somebody who cares about them. And so this is why I can understand now. I understand clearer today what I couldn't understand yesterday. Young people are joining the gang because the policemen are in a gang, the judges are in a gang, the lawyers are in a gang. They all got their own gang now. And so why should not our young people have a gang to protect them? Because when their rights are violated, like mine was violated, I was denied the right of movement in the state of Georgia, in the city of Valdosta, in the county of Lowndes, in the United States of America. And I have said it on YouTube, I have said it on my tube, I have said it on everybody's tube. But nobody gives a cotton picking nothing about your rights. And the American people had better wake up. What they teach you in civics lesson has gone down the drain. It is no longer prevalent. It is no longer real. It's only a figment of our imagination. It would have been something different if I had a police record. I did 20 years. I could have been killed in combat. I could have been killed traveling to serve this country. No. But I came home, and on May the 25th, not a gang member, not a criminal, not a person who I look to do me harm, but a member of law enforcement told me that I was under a criminal trespass warning, and not a single person in the state of Georgia, in Lowndes County, or in Valdosta have come to my aid, although the Lowndes County Sheriff had me under a criminal trespass warning that the magistrate court don't know anything about. The superior court don't know nothing about. The federal court don't know nothing about. The district attorney don't know nothing about. I called the Justice Department. My record is clean. I am not a criminal. But I have been banned from the property of the from the school. Am I in China? Am I in Russia? President Barack Obama didn't do this to me. Somebody here in Valdosta, in Lowndes County, don't like what I have exposed here. And it's gonna get worse because people now are using cameras like this. And pretty soon, the people are gonna go beyond what is being locked out because the Valdosta Daily Times won't tell our story. The TV stations are all in lockdown. How many of them call me in for me to tell my story of my rights being denied, my constitutional rights being denied? The Valdosta Daily Times editor Kay Harris know about it, but she haven't said not one thing. And she's supposed to espouse to the Constitution, the First and Second Amendment of the United States of America. So are we really a nation of laws, or are we a nation of the rich and those who are in the cliques and those who are connected? Well, you ask me, Brother Ryan, what's wrong with you? Why are you talking like this? Because I want you to understand something. This is not about black and white, because I had a white man to pull me over in front of Georgia Military College, shook my hand and gave me a donation and said, Ryan, keep telling the truth, because without your truth, this nation is going to fall apart. Now, please don't think because I'm raising my voice I'm angry. If I didn't get angry in the military as I carried the M16 to go out and kill people when my commander told me to go kill them, and I didn't have nothing against them, but when they told me to go kill, I went and I killed. So I'm a peaceful man, and I am not angry, but what I am is that I'm sincere, and I'm tired of people going to church, going to mosque, going to synagogue, and then lie and say they love Jesus, and that they follow Muhammad, and that they follow Buddha. You are a liar, and the truth is not in you. I've studied all those religions. Buddha would talk about peace. Buddha even loved the plants of the field. And Master Farad Muhammad, who was a European white man, he was the one that taught the black man Elijah Muhammad what he knew. That wasn't Elijah Muhammad teaching, because the black man don't know his history. But thank God that white European taught Elijah Muhammad what black folk must do for themselves. So it ain't about the race issue. It's about what Apostle Paul said. For we fight not against flesh and blood. The white man is flesh and blood. The Japanese is flesh and blood. The black is flesh and blood. But Paul said, we fight against powers and principalities of power and spiritual wickedness. Wickedness in high places. That's our fight. And so when you allow anybody to make you hate the white man, when you get somebody to make you hate the black man, or the Japanese man, or the Indian man, you're doing yourself a disservice. For we fight not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities of power and spiritual wickedness. Wickedness in high places. So you who see this on YouTube, I want you to understand, I got 2,500 YouTubers, and somebody don't like it because I'm telling the truth. But I want you to know that Jesus said in St. John 8:32, and ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set and make you free. And so I speak truth to you because I love you so much until I want you free. And I know that without truth, you will never be free. I don't care how much money you have. I don't care what kind of car you drive. But if you don't have truth in your heart, I don't care how much you go to church, mosque, synagogue, or temple, or atheist, and don't even go to church. If you don't have truth in your heart, you're not going to speak like I'm speaking because you don't love somebody outside of yourself. And that's what has happened to me. I fell in love with you because I fell in love with God first. God told me I can't love him unless I love all of his children. And God in heaven knows that in this house of houses, I love everybody. But at the same time, I love you so much until I got to give you the truth. Now, somebody is wondering about me because you know I've been threatened. You know what West Taylor, Lowndes County High School, said about me. said the sheriff is working on something on me because of something back in my record. Ain't a damn thing in my record. It's all in your brain. I have committed no law. I haven't broken no law. So you can look in my past all you want, and you ain't gonna find nothing but what you want to put there. So if you put drugs on my vehicle, people been knowing me since I was a child. I ain't never done drugs. You can set me up with a woman. Women ain't my weakness, and I ain't gay either. But I am the master of myself because God ordained me to do and be what I am. And by the grace of God, though I suffer and though I die by the blood of the Lamb, I shall overcome. I fear no man. I fear no beast. And I don't fear death. I don't fear death. I was born into the world to die. Blessed are they that die in the name of the Lord, for they shall rest from their labor. I am no better than Jesus. I am no better than Moses. I am no better than Jeremiah. I am no better than the dry bones in the valley. But the Bible says, the one you say you believe in, say if the righteous, if the followers of the righteous God hold their peace, then the rock's gonna cry out. I don't want no rocks crying out for me. I am a child of creation, and I care about the entire nation. Not just the nation of the United States. I care about the people in the Congo who are dying because the big countries are going over there to get the coltan. The coltan. Y'all want to talk about the coltan, where people are dying. They're going to your cell phones. And this is why the African people on that continent are in the Congo killing each other. It's not because they hate one another. It's the man behind the man. And it's the hand behind the hand. So God still have a few of us who are committed to the real Jesus that y'all dip in. You duplicate, you imitate, and you placate Jesus. But you practice the hate of Satan. You dip, and you act like Dr. King, and you act like the white founding fathers of this great republic. God inspired those white men to come set this country up. But you act like them. We got one of the best constitutions on this planet. But you dip. You duplicate them. You imitate them. You placate them. But you don't stand up for what the founding fathers stood up for. And so now it's all a game. You cover and act like you're a Christian. But in truth, you hate your very existence. And you hate those who God have created. Once again, this is KVCI.blogspot.com. George Boston Ryan doing what I do because it must be done. Bye-bye. Return to the scene of the crime. On May 25th, 2013, I was approached by Sheriff Deputy Thomas under the leadership of Sheriff Brown. As I was entering this area to go to the Lowndes County High School graduation for the year 2013, I was denied the right to attend that meeting under the heading of I had been issued, unbeknown to me, a criminal trespass warning. I was told that I would be arrested if I attempted to go to this public meeting in the state of Georgia. Witnesses were standing on this corner as Deputy Thomas gave me instructions. I then heard the radio communication over the radio that I had been under a trespass, criminal trespass warning for 2 weeks.